Can you tell us a little bit about YJ STEM? What is YJ STEM?
YJ STEM is a not-for-profit based in the USA that also owns an NGO also called YJ STEM in Liberia that uses robotics, which are robots, in order to enhance students' math, science, technology, and engineering aptitude in the classroom.
Okay. What's the overall goal for YJ STEM?
The overall goal is to bring robotics into every classroom in Liberia for 4th through 8th graders. Because robotics helps to increase the students' knowledge about their base topics like English, basic math, reading, etc. Because the students start to learn that they need those basic curriculum in order to do well in their robotics class.
Okay, you said 4th to 8th grade. Why 4th to 8th grade? How come not the lower classes as well?
Well, 4th through 8th grade is because it's a really critical time in a child's academic career where they're going to decide what they're good at, and it will direct what they're most likely to become in their careers. So if you have someone who thinks that they're not good with mathematics, for instance, they may not pursue any career that requires them to have a math aptitude. So you want to encourage the kids at that age because their minds do start to, they're in puberty basically, and they're starting to build themselves as an adult from that point. So you just want to, you know, redirect or help direct where they're going to end up so that they don't give up on, you know, their selves. In terms of what they're able to do in skill, in conceptual knowledge, et cetera.
Okay. So you said this is solely for Liberia and Liberian schools. Is that correct?
It's not solely for Liberia because this problem exists all over Africa. There's other African nations that are interested in YJ, but I started this with the heart of Liberia in mind.
Okay, so you do plan to branch out to other African countries.
And other African nations. As if they ask, I won't turn them away. YJ means for the sake of the people. And this is it's a strong name that shows that Africans, Liberians specifically, are ready to take control and responsibility of the reconstruction. It may not be our fault, what has occurred throughout centuries, you know, our generation's fault, but it is our responsibility to take care of it so that future generations can have a better quality of life.
So how many schools have you gotten the program into so far?
So far, there has been one school, but we've had a lot of achievements at that one school. The one school had about 25 students from 4th through 8th grade. Our first year piloting. But now our second year in the school, because of the YJ STEM program, that specific school called Worldwide Mission Academy recruited an additional 20 students simply because of the YJ STEM program being in that school.
Wow, that's
there are other
thousands.
Schools. It's huge. And there's other schools that are interested now because there's a demand from the students, I'm not hearing directly from administrators yet, but a lot of the students are requesting that YJ come into their school. So usually I ask them, hey, can you please speak to your teachers and your principal? And I'll meet with them.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So that says a lot, because if the students are interested in this, that means they're having fun with this, they're learning, they're growing, that they really do like the program. So with that being said, what are some of the challenges that you face with the program?
One is a major one. The teachers that we work with did not receive formal teachers training, right? Mm-hmm. And a lot of their prior responsibilities did not require them to keep up with anything administrative. So it falls into our realm of responsibility in terms of teacher training and making sure that they have the skills necessary to implement the program successfully So that's one main thing. The other thing is most of our finances are meant to go directly to the equipment necessary to carry on the curriculum, that robotics curriculum. But often we have to, when we're there visiting, we have to take additional expenses, or we have to take on additional expenses such as food and transportation. So that kind of cuts into the bill, you know, as we bring in this curriculum. That's another. But the challenges that people would expect is not what has incurred. So one of the challenges that people expected is that the robotics curriculum would be too overwhelming for the students. It was not. We take it step by step, and we build the students' confidence at certain levels. So one being vocabulary, the other one being spelling, then concepts, then actually research papers, et cetera. Now, there is a challenge within those categories, but we're very proud that the students are taking on these responsibilities in a confident way, whereas before they weren't as confident. And I'll give you an example. Simply listening to me in class, I speak standard English. And though they are also speaking English, my accent, et cetera, ends up being a barrier to their understanding. So just allowing them to be exposed to my voice, my way of speech, over time has allowed them to be more confident in understanding what I'm saying. Another challenge that existed beforehand was when I would ask a question, not only is it that the students may have not understood me, but sometimes they may have understood me but are afraid to speak out because they're afraid that their peers may laugh at them. They are afraid that I will shut them down publicly in the classroom. But all of that has since changed. The students are willing to make mistakes. The students are trying again after making a mistake. And they understand that this is just a process to gain more knowledge. So that, again, what people thought would be a challenge, which is that the kids can't take on robotics, that is not the case.
Well, that's good to know, then, that the kids are picking up and they're building their confidence. So how can parents get their kids involved in the program? What can they do if more kids want to get involved? Because it seems like they're eager. They really do like the program.
Yeah, I'm just, I'm not even surprised. I'm just really happy that the kids want to be involved. What they can do is they can visit the Worldwide Mission Standard Academy in Bassa if they are in the Buchanan community. However, other options would be to write a letter to YJ STEM on Facebook, letting me know that they are interested in having YJ STEM in their school. But I also ask that they go ahead and they speak to their principals and their teachers about bringing the program in, because we don't exist without the community being involved. So again, this is not a standalone not-for-profit. If we come into your school, we all bear the responsibility of carrying the program through, even the students.
Okay. So this program is solely going to be a program within a school system. This is not something, an entity that someone can go to. This is just within a school. This is part of a school program. Is that what I'm hearing you say?
Well, that is the way that we are bringing it forward. You can actually be very creative in how you use the program. You could do it. You could use it as an after-school program, but we advise not to, because typically what will happen is you're going to take your best students and bring them, you're going to separate them from your so-called average students. And you're going to miss out on what your so-called average students have to offer to the rest of their peers. So it's better to have it as an in-school program.
Is there a fee to join the program, the robotics program?
There's zero fee. We want to bring this to Liberian families at no cost to any of the parents.
Wow, that's a tall order. So then how do you guys go about making sure that you have all the materials and getting the program out to the children? How do you
and that's why this is
for that?
And that's why this is so, the name is so important, YJ. This is not Gyawi Gya standing alone. We have the support of Senator Conga, Senator Conga in, she's a head senator, Yumbly Conga Lawrence in, for Bassa. She actually owns the Yumbly Care Foundation. Yumbly Care Foundation owns the Worldwide Mission Academy. She has invested her trust in YJ STEM. We've been given, you know, power to go into the schools, train the teachers, et cetera. I have a strong board behind me medical doctors, of artificial intelligence, you know, people who build robots and allow them to do develop humanistic characteristics. I have people who've been in oil and gas for over 20 years, people who've been in other NGO entities helping out Africa for over 15 years. I have friends, I have families, I have old church associates and friends that have all decided to step up and help. So this is not something that I do alone. YJ, for the sake of the people, that means the people also have to put in, you know, effort in order for this to be successful. I've been really proud of our teachers. The teachers have stepped up. Some of them even put their own money into the program when there is nothing. Mm. Yes.
That's impressive.
So when they're out of something, they say, they don't look to me and say, oh, Gewi, we need this. They know they need whatever it is, and so they go out and they get it because they understand the whole mission of this this organization, and they know that they are a part of the organization.
Mm-hmm. Would you say, what are the ratio of boys to girls? Would you say there are more boys interested in the robotics or more girls interested in the robotics?
I'm smiling because the girls and the boys are very interested in robotics, and they show it in similar ways. What the girls have learned is that they should speak up. You have to speak up to be heard, because that's something that I see naturally inclined in women, both in developed and developing nations, that the girls or females may be aware of a solution or an answer to a problem, right? Mm-hmm. But they are less inclined to speak up for many reasons that we can't go through on this call. So encouraging them to speak up through in a way where we show positive consequences to speaking up. For the boys, they have shown a lot of interest as well in terms of speaking up. But they're speaking up, the reason that they were more timid in speaking up was more so in fear of having the wrong answer, whereas the girls, they are in fear of speaking up because they thought that their peers would laugh at them.
So
understanding those differences in both the boys and the girls, but getting them to work together.
What are some of the creations? What are some of the things that they've created? Like, what can the robots do?
Okay, so at first, they have a template that will help them put basically some kind of like Lego pieces together to build to build a prototype of a robot, or to build the actual robot, not the prototype, an actual robot. Then they have something called a CPU, and the CPU is basically like your computer when you turn it on. So there's a CPU built onto the robot. Well, then the students actually go through something called C+ programming. That's a language for programming, and they type in this code that only the computer and the robot can understand. And then they use a wire to move it's kind of like a USB stick in a way, where you put your USB in the computer and you save some information on that USB. That's how that CPU on the robot works. So you talk a language to the computer that it understands. You basically put this cord between the computer and the CPU on the robot, and then you move the code from the computer to the robot. Also, the students have been going through different challenges. There are challenges like, hey, pick up 3 rings of something, move those rings across a field, and then put those rings on top of a pole that is stabilized on the field. Also, and there's two ways that they're doing the programming. It's something called teleoperated, where you speed up code while a human being is actually controlling the controller. And then there's another way where you do automation, where you can have the robot move on its own. So all the rage right now are self-driving cars. That would be an example of automation. For the teleoperated, it'd be like, let me see. I hope this is not too basic of an example, but it would be like you checking in at the airport instead of using a human being to check you. You would instead go to a machine, put in your passport information or your payment information, and then it takes the process. So you're working with a machine to make something happen. Or even another example would be, I wonder if go-karts have, I think go-karts might have some type of CPU in them. But you're doing the controlling. So
yeah,
I don't want to go.
You're turning the wheel.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You're turning the wheel, but there's all this programming inside that go-kart. Or your even your car. A car is actually a teleoperated car. The cars that we drive right now, your Hondas and your Toyotas and all those, they have them. And you're actually operating the car, but the car knows how to steer because there's coding already inside of it. Some people have these light fixtures, right? Or you've been in a place where there's a light fixture in a commercial building, and maybe the lights are off in the restroom, let's say. You have a commercial restroom, you have a light in there, but it's only when you open the door do you see the lights come on, or even your refrigerator, something like that. Mm-hmm.
So the kids are learning to do all of those things, to build robots that can do any such things that you code it to do. Is that what I'm hearing you say?
Well, right now they're limited in how they can code, but they're aware of all of these other possibilities out in the world. But typically what they're doing is they're setting up the robot to accomplish certain tasks on the field, on a pre-built field.
So let's just go back over how people can get, what's the information? How can they get to YJ STEM?
Okay, YJ STEM, you can find us on Facebook. The word is YJ, WAHJAY, in space, or dash, STEM, STEM for mother. Also, you can find us on YJSTEM.org. And also, you can Google YJ STEM, WAHJAY, space, STEM. And you can find a lot of our material online.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much, Gary. Much good luck to you and your team. I think you have started something amazing. And I know it will only take off from here going forward. Because as much it's needed in Liberia, so much. Any last words?
No, I just want to thank the Liberians for welcoming me into the country and appreciating the work that has been done. But most especially, I want to thank Senator Yumbly Conga Lawrence for providing a platform for YJ to exercise what we said we would do. And I look forward to the upcoming year. We're actually closing this year off with about 6 or 7 of the kids. We've already pre-selected them, so it's all about raising the funding. That's why it's 6 or 7 kids. if we can raise enough funding, these kids will return back to the USA to represent Liberia at the VEX, V-E-X, World Competition 2018. We are very excited. We just completed our second annual robotics competition at, in Liberia, hosted by YJSTEM, and now we're working with the Yumbly Cares Foundation as a partner. We both financially contribute to the kids arriving to the USA in Louisville, Kentucky, to participate in the VEX World Competition to compete against countries like China, India, the U.S., Russia, Paraguay, Mexico, et cetera. It gets the kids exposed to what else is going on in the world outside of Liberia, gets their imagination going, and they return to Liberia wanting to do greater and better things. Right now we have a fundraiser going on Facebook, so you can search for us on Facebook, YJ STEM, WAHJAYSTEM, 2 words. Or you can go on our website, yjstem.org, and hit the donate button. We're actually trying to raise $12,000. It's a really big feat, but we will see what we can do.
Yeah. And we're here to support you in any way that we can. So Liberian Dad Extraordinaire, we're behind you and behind this program 100%. So thank you so much for all the hard work, and good luck to the team.
I appreciate you. Thank you.
All right.
That was Gaby Gia of YJ STEM. Thank you for listening. I'm Jamade of Liberian Dad Extraordinaire. Please like, comment, and share this interview. And also subscribe to our YouTube channel for all things positive on Liberia. We are changing the narrative, one Liberian Dad at a time.